heaven and earth. We have some of them in purgatory and some in heaven. But we are all one with the family, and each part of the family can help the other. We could pray for the souls in purgatory, and they could pray for us, and the saints pray for us. So the family is one with the family, and each part helping the other. Okay? So it's part of our family. So Mary and the saints are part of our family, of the church family. Alright?
Alright.
Now we said the Eucharist, the power of the Eucharist. I hope you know the Mass is the most powerful prayer in the world. There's nothing in the world more powerful than a Catholic Mass. Nothing in the world is more powerful than a Catholic Mass. Why? Okay. Because the Mass is the prayer of Jesus. What happens at Mass? At Mass, what happened at Calvary, Jesus does that on the altar. What happened on Calvary? On Calvary, Jesus offered himself to his Father for the human race. In the Mass, Jesus comes down from heaven and does the same thing, offering himself to his Father. So the Mass is the prayer of Jesus. Why is that important? Any prayer, any request, it gets its power from relationship. You get what you want because of your relationship with the person you pray to. Suppose you have a kingdom and a king. You have a problem in the kingdom. A stranger comes to the king and says, Mr. King, would you kindly do this for us, fix this? The king might take him on, but the king has a favorite daughter. And she comes and she says, Papa, do something here. Who are you going to listen to? The daughter, because of the relationship. Now, who has the best relationship with God the Father? Who is that? Jesus, of course. He's the beloved Son. He has the best relationship with the Father. And that means his prayer